Hey everyone, so today I have with me the second iteration of DJI's miniature cameras, the DJI Pocket 2. But do not underestimate its size because you can shoot some really amazing videos with this one. Basically, it comes in two variations. One is the normal pack where you get the camera itself and some other basic things, while there's also the Creator's Combo pack, which is the one I have with me right now. This package right here is especially designed for creators and comes with a bunch of additional accessories like a microphone, an additional wide-angle lens, a cute little tripod, a joystick controller, and a do-it-all handle. If you're confused about which one you should get, well, unless you are a video creator, a professional, or a die-hard enthusiast, getting the Creator's Combo Pack is not going to be very fruitful in my opinion. But regardless of which version you choose, you get this cover slash protector that comes really handy while shooting because apart from the camera itself, it can fit the wide-angle lens and a couple of other things inside which helps manage your stuff. Anyways, onto the camera now. The DJI Pocket 2 is probably one of the smallest cameras I've ever used. Its form factor is very similar to its previous version and it fits in your hands really easily. So even with long hours of shooting, the Pocket 2 does not get uncomfortable. It's just that the placement of the power button sucks and even when you're just holding the camera, you tend to accidentally press it. Having said that, you do get a longer extender called a do-it-all handle that helps the situation a bit. Now talking of the buttons, on the front there are two, one for recording while the other button lets you switch between photo and video modes. As I mentioned earlier, there's also this joystick controller that needs to be attached separately. The joystick helps control the gimbal movements and this button on the side is for changing the gimbal settings. Talking about the gimbal, the DJI Pocket 2 has a 3-axis stabilizer that lets you choose between tilt lock, follow and FPV modes. Still, a slight letdown in the design front is the fact that this camera does not have any kind of waterproofing, so you will have to be extra careful with it. However, there's a separate case that can waterproof the device, but the catch is that you will have to buy it separately. Anyway, before getting to the core camera performance, let's talk about what these cameras are capable of first. Using the DJI Pocket 2, you can shoot stable normal footages up to 4K 60fps, 64 megapixel photos, panoramas, time lapses, and slow-mo at 1080p resolution in either 120 or 240fps. Talking of the core camera performance, I have loved how the contents shot from it are sharp and portray very natural colors. I used the Insta360 ONE R cameras before this one and the footages from it looked very color processed straight out of the cameras, so if you like a subtle yet a natural color tone, then the DJI Pocket 2 is a treat. And that's not just in the rare footages, the camera does maintain a natural color tone in selfie videos as well. If you have watched our review of the Insta360 ONE R cameras, you would know that its selfie videos don't have very good colors. But from the Pocket 2, I faced no problems regarding color reproduction or skin tone. Note that I clicked all the videos in auto mode, while there's also a pro mode which is just like manual mode in cameras that lets you play around with ISO, white balance, shutter speed and such. Now back to its video capabilities, the stabilization even in the highest of resolutions is commendable. Here's a video of me running and it's evident from the footage that this camera can handle movements very well. Plus, because this one's a gimbal plus camera, you can shoot in different modes and get creative shots without much hassle. As mentioned in the beginning, there's a wide-angle lens too that attaches magnetically to the camera and lets you shoot with a wider perspective whenever you deem necessary. Also, I love its active track feature. Basically, it actively tracks the subject's movements and tries to keep them in the frame. This feature is really useful when you're recording by yourself as you don't need another person to adjust the frame for you all the time. So if you make dance covers or if you are a vlogger, I am sure you know how much this feature will make your life easier. Now moving on, I also tested its camera quality in nighttime and well, it's nothing out of the ordinary. The footage does not come out grainy even at extremely low light conditions though, such as this one where my sister is feeding stray dogs at night. To top things off, I can assure you that the footage from the Pocket 2 has turned out brighter than the actual ambient lighting. Moving on, the DJI Pocket 2 can also shoot photos in either 16 or 64 megapixel resolution. They are not as sharp as you would get from your smartphone, but are okay for casual photography. Additionally, it lets you shoot in RAW format too, so you will be able to post-process it as you like. Now, you might have noticed that the content display screen here is rather small, which is to be expected from a pocket-sized camera, but it also makes it difficult to view or record videos. To counter this problem, DJI lets you connect your smartphone with the Pocket 2. All you have to do is attach the USB-C connector to the camera like this and then connect your smartphone. Now, you can view the camera's content directly on the phone in real time through the DJI Mimo app. And because you have to take off the gimbal controller to attach the said USB-C connector, the app facilitates by providing all the camera and gimbal functions on the app itself. By the way, the company provides a separate lightning connector too for the iPhone users. You can also connect to the DJI Pocket 2 wirelessly via Bluetooth or Wi-Fi, but for that you will have to attach the do-it-all handle. Now talking about the app, it is very simple and easy to get along with. I like the fact that DJI gives all the information on how to get started and operate the camera through the app itself. There's also something called an AI editor that helps you effortlessly generate attractive videos. There are several templates with different themes that you can apply to your content and make them interesting and fun. All you have to do is choose a bunch of relevant footage and select the theme you prefer, and that's it. You have your video right there. But I do have to tell you that the Insta360 ONE R cameras I reviewed before this one had a more extensive selection of such templates in its app, which was a lot more fun than what DJI offers. Okay, besides all this, I was also really curious to know how the DJI Pocket 2's video capabilities fared against high-end smartphones like the iPhone 12 Pro Max that boasts 4K 60fps resolution and OIS along with the new sensor shift technology. So I compared this camera with the iPhone 12 Pro Max. First off, I found a difference in color processing where the DJI Pocket 2 had very natural colors out of the camera. I noticed the dynamic range to be pretty similar while the iPhone 12 Pro Max had slightly sharper output. The main point of difference, however, lied in the stabilization front. While you walk at a steady pace, both of them give out a similar output, but when you run or have abrupt movements, the DJI Pocket 2 outshines the 12 Pro Max by a huge margin, all thanks to its 3-axis gimbal stabilization. So yeah, the DJI Pocket 2 adamantly goes beyond the capabilities of a flagship smartphone. It is a capable action camera with a gimbal that even professionals can get behind. To conclude, I think the DJI Pocket 2 is a great miniature camera. Its main selling point is most definitely the fact that it is an incredibly portable 2-in-1 camera plus gimbal that can shoot some amazingly stable footages. As a result, it's a great option for beginner videographers and vloggers. Also, using the DJI Pocket 2 is not a hassle like with other action cameras that I've tested out recently where you have to carry a lot of separate accessories like selfie stick, monopod, etc. In contrast, the DJI Pocket 2 is very easy to get along with.